welcome back. I'm making friends, and thank you guys for tuning in today. I hope you guys had an awesome week thus far and that you're excited about today's lesson. Today's topic is the betrayal. Betrayal is a violation of one's trust or confidence of a moral standard. Betrayal is disloyalty. Have you ever been betrayed by someone who was close to you? That's not a good feeling, right? I'm sure you guys remember the story of Judas in Luke chapter 22. Judas was very dear to Jesus. In fact, Judas was one of Jesus' 12 disciples. He was a treasurer. Jesus trusted Judas, but Judas became very greedy, and he chose to hand Jesus over to a crowd for 30 pieces of silver. He basically chose greed over loyalty. Can you imagine how Jesus felt in that very moment when his own friend betrayed him? Once Judas got Jesus arrested, he felt so bad inside and he felt so much regret, but it was too late. He already made the decision. He made the deal to hand Jesus over to the chief priest in the crowd. And I know you're wondering, what did Jesus do in that situation? Well, Jesus did something that most of us will be hesitant in doing. He forgave him. Can you actually forgive someone who betrayed you? Well, I know being betrayed at a young age, it helped me to see things for what they really are. And as I grow in my walk with Christ, I've learned how to deal with my Judas. Now I'm going to show you a few ways on how you can deal with your Judas. Number one, speak up. Make sure you bring it to your friend's attention whenever you feel that he or she has betrayed you. You have to make it known. Number two, forgive. As hard as it may be, you have to forgive those who've wronged you. If not, you'll be hindering yourself from blessings and growth. Number three, learn from it. Allow the betrayal to show you how to treat others. Remember how it felt when you were betrayed so that you won't betray others. Number four, set boundaries. Just because you forgive a person does not mean you have to keep them in your inner circle. Sometimes people are just not trustworthy, and you may have to deny this person access to certain areas of your life. Make sure boundaries are in place. Number five, pray. Always pray for the person who betrayed you. Pray for their hearts. You will be amazed at how God changes things. I want you to know that some people are only seasonal in your life, and every obstacle that you face, you must learn from it. When you are betrayed, choose to forgive and learn how to navigate through it and keep your blessings flowing. Let's pray out. Lord, help us to make the right decisions. Guard our tongue and protect our heart. We ask that you will open our hearts and allow us to forgive those as you've forgiven us. We thank you, Lord, and we love you. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for tuning in today. I hope to see you again. Remember, the time changed. Make sure you tune in. See you then. Just give them worship. Yeah.